is adult entertainment and romantic comedy setting men and women up for failure. Hey guys, welcome back to the Dumbcat channel. I came across a really interesting article in the New York Post about this 32-year-old woman from Rochester, New York, who talked about never being kissed or being on a date until recently. 32 years old, haven't really been on a date. I thought it was really interesting that she said never been kissed and never been on a date, because just because she's never been kissed doesn't mean she hasn't done other things. I thought that. So I guess we're to assume that she is a virgin, but you can't really make that assumption, because that's my first takeaway from that right off the bat. But I saw the image of the lady, and she's an average-looking woman. Not a bad looking woman, just an average person. And that's most of us. Most of us are just average people, right? And she said she's a late bloomer. She said that the article sort of mentioned Drew Barrymore and his romantic comedies or whatever. She's the real life Drew Barrymore. I read it and I thought to myself, okay, first of all, I wonder if these romantic comedies are having a really detrimental effect on these women. Maybe it's affecting her expectations. The article sort of talked a little bit about her expectations. She said at one point she lost trust in love. So I'm wondering, something must have happened. You know, for 15 years, she said she focused on her career, which is something you hear a lot from women now, focus on their career. But they sort of put the family thing to the side. But then they hit a certain age and it's like, okay, I need to change things up. But the thing is, two weird things happen. When they get to that later age, they become so focused on, okay, let's start a family and all this stuff. They sort of turn a lot of guys off. They sort of scare a lot of guys away. If they would have started at an earlier age, they would have had more options, especially if they have very high expectations. But it's just something I just saw right off of the bat. And first of all, those romantic comedies are completely unrealistic. Most of them are completely unrealistic. I mean, I know that I like watching romantic comedies. I like watching romantic shows. I like watching action shows, thrillers, you know, it's entertainment. I'll look at that stuff and say, okay, that should be my life. Okay, I didn't watch the Terminal List and thought I should be taking people out to lunch or whatever you want to say. You know, I mean, you know, what I just enjoy, I consume it as entertainment. Like watching this one show right now called Perfect Match, which is a really trashy reality. It's a dating show. I hate those type of shows. But there's some really good looking women on the show and they're really entertaining. Francesca, whatever her name is. She's terrible, but she's fun to watch. I don't look at this stuff and think, oh, yeah, this is the real world. You know, I don't look at that and say, okay, I'm going to make life decisions. I'm going to let this affect my perspective. Or maybe it is affecting my perspective, but I don't even know about it. I don't know. Maybe that's the case. Okay, and then you have adult entertainment and all that stuff, how that may impact men as well. Maybe that's creating expectations, problems for guys. They expect certain things. Certain perfection for women when it comes to intimate things, or maybe these guys are just giving up. I'll talk about that in another video. But this woman, she talks about, they sort of hinted at her expectations, but she finally found a date recently. She found a guy she can connect with. And, you know, she said she was able to tell this guy that she hasn't been kissed or whatever. I mean, if a woman says she's a virgin at 32, I'm assuming she's a virgin. That's not going to freak out a guy. You know, guys, maybe, whether they believe it or not, I mean, it's not going to freak a guy out. You know, if you're a guy and you say that to a woman, I've never been kissed or, I mean, that's not good. That's just the difference in the dynamic between men and women, you know. So do you think people have unrealistic expectations in the dating market right now? When I think of expectations, I'm sorry, I keep thinking of that MADtv skit, Lowered Expectations. I want to sing that jingle so bad. I remember that skit with Stuart and his mom. It's like, no. I love that show. That skit, there's certain skits like on shows like MADtv and the whole idea behind Lowered Expectations, that skit was that, you know, you're not gonna find your dream person. You know, you can't get a date, but if you want to be with somebody, you're gonna have to lower your expectations. So here's a clip of someone who's lowered their expectations, somebody who you might be interested if you lower your expectations. And the lady who does the intro to it is so funny. I mean, she says it so seriously. She's like, this is brilliant. So if you find those clips online, Lowered Expectations, I want to sing the jingle so bad. I gotta warn you, once you hear it, you're gonna be seeing it a lot. It's so simple and it's so funny. But anyway, yeah, I think she probably had unrealistic expectations early on. Maybe she experienced some type of rejection. I know a lot of women don't do well with rejection. When you're a man, you got to deal with it. That's just part of life. But a lot of women, they get really hostile when you reject them. So that's another question I would put out there for you guys. One, do you think a lot of these women have unrealistic expectations? Do you think guys have unrealistic expectations when it comes to intimacy because of adult entertainment? Do you think women have unrealistic expectations for men overall when it comes to pretty much everything? And maybe that's influenced because of the culture. So those are some questions I would have for you guys right there. Thank you guys for watching. Thanks for listening. Don't forget the future belongs to those who prepare for it today.